Good evening and welcome to another episode of Topics on the Hill. I am your host, Marika Parkinson, and as always, I am here with...
Akeem. All right, Marika, it's been a while since you have been here, doesn't it?
Yes, it's been a long while. Have you missed Topics on the Hill? Have you been hosting?
Well, yes, but today is the final episode, Marika.
You look sad.
Do I look sad?
Yes,
all good things
sad.
Must come to a pause.
Absolutely. It does seem that it has been a long time, but we're happy to be back.
I hope our audience didn't miss us too much during the Easter break, but we are thrilled to have you joining us online via our YouTube platform at NCU TV Jamaica. I encourage you to share the link with a friend, as this evening we have quite an interesting show for you.
This evening's episode is a special one. It's all about mastering leadership, unlocking your full potential. We have a wonderful discussion lined up just for you. You can also look forward to our Stars on the Hill feature and drum roll. The announcement of the 2024 USM candidates. I am certain you do not want to miss that.
Wonderful. We are going to take a short break. But before we unpack all this episode for you, we are going to turn things over to our Topical View host, Matthew Wright. Matthew, what's going on?
Well, I'm going to tell you what's going on, Akeem. Now, viewers, whenever you see this face, just understand that this is the face of Matthew J. Wright. And also, it will be time to hear your opinions, your voices heard right here on the show for Topical View. And how you get your voices heard? You just simply answer the feedback question. And for this episode, the feedback question is, in your opinion, what specific skills or qualities are essential for someone to be recognized as a strong and effective leader, especially in a student leadership role like the upcoming USM elections? Let me say that again for those in the back. In your opinion, what skills or qualities are essential for someone to be recognized as a strong leader, especially as a role in the upcoming USM elections? Now you can send your replies right below in the chat on NCU TV Jamaica, or just slide in our DMs at on Instagram at Topics on the Hill. So I just want you to stay right there and start typing. Topics on the Hill will be right back.
Together we achieve.
Joining clubs isn't just about finding your niche. It's about unlocking a world of opportunities. The United Student Movement brings together an array of clubs. Each offering a unique platform for growth, learning, and connection.
Explore your passion, hone your skills, and expand your horizons. Whether you're an aspiring entrepreneur, an environmental activist, an artist, or a sports enthusiast, there's a club just for you.
My sports host helped me to find a second family away from home.
Through our USM project team, I have made a real difference in our community.
Being part of the Computer Hardware and Information Processing Specialist Club has really boosted my confidence and critical thinking skills.
Clubs are not just extracurricular, they're the heartbeat of campus life. They provide a network of support, a platform to voice your ideas, and a space to make lasting friendships.
Join the movement and embrace the power of collective action. Stand together, learn from one another, and create a legacy that lasts beyond us.
Ready to dive in? Visit us at usm.edu.jn and find your place in the United Student Movement. Let your journey begin, because together we're stronger.
Follow us on social media, visit our website, and become a part of something extraordinary. The NCU United Student Movement, where your voice, your ideas, and your passion shape the future.
Join us today.
Welcome back to Topics on the Hill. As mentioned earlier, we are diving headfirst into the world of leadership. But we're not just talking about it. We will be explaining what the importance of trusting your leader while doing an obstacle challenge. How is it, how hard is it for you, or how difficult it is for you to trust a leader when doing an obstacle course, Akim?
You know, well, doing an obstacle course, I'm going to put it blindfolded.
Mm-hmm.
If you are with someone you can trust, say can it is trust. Your best friend.
Your best friend. What if it's not your best friend?
Oh, that is... Well, if it is a friend that you can trust, you know, you can go blindfolded.
What and if
it
it's
depends.
Not a
and
friend?
It depends on the obstacle. Yes.
What if it's not a friend? It's mm-hmm. just somebody who just appears to be your partner for that obstacle.
Well, being that it is my partner in that obstacle, I would have to trust him. And I would have to trust the person on the left.
All right. So in that case, you will have a leader. Mm-hmm. But how do you navigate when the path isn't clear? How do you listen and mm-hmm. communicate to unlock the latent potential mm-hmm. in your team? Leadership is not just about reaching the end. Mm-hmm. It's about the growth that occurs as you overcome each hurdle.
Yep. And there are two pillars of leadership that we need to understand.
Mm-hmm.
It is having trust, as you mentioned,
yes.
to step into the unknown and to be trusted.
That's
and,
right.
And then we, by doing that, we will unlock the full potentials within ourselves and that, within others too.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. So the USM election is but a few days away, and in a matter of minutes, you will hear the list of candidates. We went on campus this week to hear some of the qualities students are looking for in the next elected leaders. Our Topics in the Street host Marlene Freeman shares more. Let us have a look at that.
Episode of Topics in the Street. Today, we'll be asking our students, in your opinion, what specific skills or qualities are essential for someone to be recognized as a strong and effective leader, especially in a student leadership role like the upcoming USM elections. Let's go. Hello, what's your name? I'm Kenrick. I believe that the leadership first, they must recognize God as your leader because when you recognize God as your leader, He will send His Holy Spirit to lead you, and when you are led by the Spirit of God, He will lead you in the initiatives that you need to reach other people effectively.
The ability to listen is very important. From time to time, students, myself, will share their opinions, and They must have a sense of creativity, should be good listeners, open to questions, open to everything really.
Because we're in a college setting and you just have to believe in yourselves as well and put your trust in God. Believe that they can do it. And just try their best.
I believe that for, especially for student leaders, qualities that you need to have is honesty. You need to be open with your communication to your students, you know, because a lot of times with our student leaders, we believe that they are going to do what they say in their manifestos, and then at the end of the day, a lot of the things that they say they're going to do, they don't actually do. You know, we need consistency and competency, because a lot of the times, just like how they don't speak to us. They just, it feels at least like they just want the position to be able to look at their resume and say, oh, I was the VP of this, or I was the president of this. So I feel like definitely what we need is honesty, competency, consistency, and communication.
Well, guys, there you have it. The students have spoken on who they think is a strong and effective leader. This was your final episode of Topics in the Street. I'm your host, Marley.
And that was Topics in the Street with Marlene Freeman, our segment host. Thanks again, Marlene, for getting those responses from fellow students around campus. So joining us to share more on the topic is Vice President of Local and International Affairs for the Jamaica Union of Tertiary Students, Tavoy Barrett. Tavoy will be sharing his experience as a student leader and a few tips on how you can unlock your full leadership potential.
Yes, we are definitely looking forward to speak with Mr. Tavoy Barrett. Good afternoon, Mr. Barrett.
All right, so it seems as if we are having some technical issues, so we are going to take a quick break and we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Eating and sleeping are priorities. Love your body, a healthier you.
So the USM Bible Bowl is here, ladies and gentlemen. And what are we going to be looking at? We're going to be looking at the most famous stories in Genesis. We're going to be looking at the parables in Matthew, the last couple of chapters in the Great Controversy. So if you desire to be a part of a team for Bible Bowl, April 20th, 2024, contact your club's spiritual affairs vice president, or contact a club's spiritual vice president, and then you'll be able to be added to a team. Come out in your numbers and celebrate with us as we aim to crown the next 2024 Bible Bowl champion. Come on with us. Champions.
With Mr. Tavoy Barrett. Good afternoon, Mr. Barrett. We are still not hearing him. So in the meantime, Akeem,
yes.
We're talking about leadership today. Can you share your experience with our audience with being a leader?
Well, being a leader was back in high school when I was a head boy of Clarendon College. Big
that.
Up Clarendon College
Look
all the time, 1CC. It was in the time of COVID. So you know that we have a lot to do as student leaders. And one of the things that I learned being a leader at that time, you never know your full potential until you're in the shoe full potential. So being a leader, it is not easy and it is not hard.
It's not impossible because as Philippians 4:13 says, we can do
all things
through Christ who strengthens us. So as you spoke about leadership and your role as the head boy at Clarendon College, what are some of the challenges that you would have encountered?
What an impromptu interview, huh?
That's fine.
Right, it is fine. We must prepare for anything in this media industry.
Yes, but that's what leaders are for.
Preparing for the unknown. But one of the challenges that I experienced as a leader, because I wasn't the type back then to do public speaking or all of that, you know. So I found it challenging to relate to students when they're having issues. I found it challenging to bring those issues to the board of the school because, you know, you have to speak on behalf of the students.
The students, that's right.
So that was a bit challenging for me, but I did it nonetheless.
And here you are today as a media practitioner.
Look at God.
Yes. Probably you did not know then that you wanted to study in the field of media and communications. But being in that role, it would have prepared you for where you are today. And
that's
I can
right.
say the same thing too, because something as simple as leading a group, it is very critical how you lead your fellow peers and your group members, because people have different backgrounds, they have different understanding of different things, and you have to be open and understanding and ensure that you are leading people in a charismatic way. Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, the goal is achieved.
Yes, and I must say, Marika, that a leader needs a leader.
Yes, and I think our audience wants you to expound on that.
Yes, I will. A leader needs a leader in the sense that you are the one leading. You ever hear the statement that a counselor needs a counselor?
Yes.
Yes. So in that same sense, a leader needs a leader where that leader is experiencing challenges.
They have someone to rely on.
That leader wants someone to talk to. So a leader do needs a leader. And go ahead.
And on that note, we are here to rely on Mr. Tavoy Barrett. Good afternoon, Mr. Barrett.
Good afternoon, everybody. Can you hear me now?
Yes, we are. Happy to have you with us this afternoon. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Thank you guys for having me on.
Awesome. It's our pleasure to have you here to talk about leadership. So tell us about your journey to becoming a student leader.
My journey to becoming a student leader, I think similar to Akim, started back in high school. So in high school, I would have served as deputy head boy at the last time. You know, there were a few roles before that, but upon leaving high school, I served as deputy head boy and then started UTEC. And when I started UTEC, I got involved in dorm, did a few, because the dorm is a place where you are, I don't want to say pressured, but you are highly encouraged into leadership or towards that trajectory. Mm-hmm. So being on dorm, being around some of the guys who were a part of the student union, but then I think it was just like a mental nudge towards leadership. Mm-hmm. Eventually, after that period of time, in my first year, I eventually became a part of the FMA executive, subsequently becoming president of the Future Marketers Association. And then from there, I became a youth parliamentarian, vice president of the Students Union at UTEC, and most recent president of the Students Union. I think it's almost like a chain reaction where once I get involved, it's almost like no stopping from there. Mm-hmm. You know, they always say the reward for good work is more work. Mm-hmm. So now I serve as the second vice president for the Jamaica Union of Tertiary Students. So I think that's essentially in a nutshell the trajectory from high school into where I am now.
Okay. So assuming all those leadership roles, what are some of the challenges you have had thus far?
I don't think anybody ever gets away from the challenge of balance. Mm-hmm. And I don't even know if I should say it's a challenge or it's more so just an active skill that you have to gain and adjust to every single time. So each leadership role demands a different expectation, a different execution of the job function. So ultimately, and at time in your life, you're also at a different stage or place. You're working, you're going to, you have different courses at the time. So you have to figure out the balance for that specific period. Mm-hmm. So I think that's one thing. And then in addition to that, it's also like building your emotional intelligence. I think that's very important for leaders because especially in the space and place that we are in now, we have to first know how to manage our emotions and then in order to support and lead others.
Mm-hmm. All right, so you'd have spoke about balance and emotional intelligence. What are some of the qualities that good leaders possess and how can students develop those qualities if they don't already possess them?
Mm-hmm. So I think somebody said one of them earlier in the street, what's it called? Topic on the street teacher. And one of them is being able to listen. So listen and take criticism. So you have to be able to stand up to the point where people are going to say, I don't think you did this right, I don't think you did that right, et cetera, et cetera. And then from there, from that criticism, take away what's the most important thing. At the end of the day, people will talk because they are able to talk. People will judge your leadership because they are able to. But you have to also look beyond whatever is categorized or classified as noise and figure out what from that is of value. What can I take from this? That is something that I actually need to implement for students, or something that I actually need to work on or push for, advocate for. Mm-hmm. And then again, the points around emotional intelligence. Some time ago, I got this tip from someone that to build your emotional intelligence, you have to work on understanding and identifying other people's emotions. Mm-hmm. And for one, so that the activity or idea, and it might sound weird, but trust me, it works. Just go into any public space, and just sit down and look at just people watch. Just look at people, look at what they're going through, and try to understand. I mean, you can never guess or figure out what somebody's going through, but just by sitting down and you looking at somebody and trying to say, all right, cool, they ordered something and it came out wrong, yeah, man, they're going to be upset. Or they are upset and you're trying to just break down the situation into what could the server do to make that right, you know? So the more you kind of get into the habit of understanding other people's emotions, even in those simple instances and situations, it helps you know when you get into a much bigger space, a bigger picture where, I don't want to say life or death, but it comes down to the point where you have to now decide, do I react to this message or I react to this person in a negative way, or do I stop and say, thank you for sharing that, let's explore that feeling some more, as opposed to responding negatively, similar way that they did. But yeah, so those are two things. And in an effort to work on to work on like balance, I tell people all the time that you have to be okay with prioritizing and knowing what's not a priority. And if it don't make it on the priority list, then so be it. But at the end of the day, you also have to prioritize you, your health, and in the case of student leadership, your own academics, because you don't want to have everything going except for school.
Academics. Right. And I think another characteristic or another quality that good leaders should have is being confident. Mm-hmm. But how do you define unlocking your full potential, and what steps would you advise students to take to achieve that in their leadership roles?
So unlocking your potential starts with having an idea of where you're going or where you want to go. And at the very least, you have to have an idea of what's the bigger picture. The bigger picture in the sense that, how do I use my role or my leadership to advance the life of someone else? Mm-hmm. How do I use my leadership to advance or to support my own growth and development?
Okay, so go ahead.
There's this narrative or approach that, you know, you don't want to go into a role and thinking about what you can benefit or who you can be in. Mm-hmm. But it's very important to understand what's your own bias and how your biases mm-hmm. will affect or impact how you execute your role. So I know that I want to get into marketing, or I want to get into public relations, I'm going to run for the public relations role. Wow. I have to be able to clearly say, am I doing this because I know that this is my end goal, or am I doing this because I want to serve and ensure that the USM communicates effectively to students?
Awesome. So you have a wealth of knowledge, a lot of experiences as it relates to being a leader. What advice would you give to other students who aspire to become leaders, but they may be a little hesitant to step forward to acquire or to accept those roles? What advice would you give to them?
People are quick to say, oh, but I don't have any experience, I don't know what to do. My unpopular belief is that non-leaders sometimes make the best leaders. So if you think, oh, I'm not prepared, I just don't know what to do. You see, once you have an attitude and a willingness to learn, you make potentially one of the best leaders or could make one of the best leaders. So you just have to be open to learning. And even if you're a seasoned leader, you've done this before, you have to be open and willing to learn. You can't be stubborn, you can take correction, especially from people who have been there before you, have done the role or the capacity or position that you are going for. You have to go up to them and ask, hey, how do you do this? I'm having this challenge, what do you think? And if they come to you and say, hey, you know, this is the situation you should do, or I'd suggest that you have to be open and humble enough to take that advice, but then also confident enough to say, all right, I get your point, but I'm also going to put this on the table as a possible direction. But you have to be humble enough where you can take correction, take direction, and take advice from people that have been there before. And for the people who think that, oh, I don't have any experience, I don't know. Again, my unpopular belief is that as long as you have an attitude and a willingness to learn, then you could potentially be the best leader.
Good advice. We are going to take a short break, but first, let's go over to our social media host, Matthew Wright.
Well, Morica, let me tell you, the answers are buzzing in. So, you know, as I mentioned early in the show, or if you're just joining, whenever you see my face, you will understand that it is time to have your voices heard. And in essence, we wanted to know this episode, what are some of the qualities you think makes a great student leader, especially as it relates to the upcoming USM elections? Now, Carlos is saying that as a college student, I believe that a good leader must be approachable, because sometimes, especially in the USM, you need to be, if you want to voice your concerns, we need to feel safe as students to come and talk to you about anything, which I think that's true. Yeah, I believe that as well. All right, let's look at it. Cheyenne is saying that a good leader has to be a visionary, because, of course, you have to come with great ideas to improve upon what the last regime may have conquered. That's what she's saying right here. And I believe so as well. It really does remind me of a past USM president, Giovanni Brown, who was quite the visionary. Well, I just want you to keep your answers coming for when we return for the next set for Topical View. Is it Topical View? Yes, it's Topical View. My floor manager just confirmed it for me. I'm just excited, so my brain kind of... But I just want you to stay right there. We will be right back with some more topics on the Hill.
Walk it out. Talk it out. Nobody fight it out.
Hey you, here's a resolution for you. Mark your calendar says April 14, we gather for the Lingnam Vitae Film Festival, LVFF, for 2024. This time around, we look at themes surrounding conquering or service. Yes, it's the annual NCU Film Showcase, the Lingnam Vitae Film Festival. Don't miss it.
Only because of grace.
Getting so close.
As an Israeli living in Israel, at least now the world understands.
How many would die if Russia's nuclear arsenal?
If China and Taiwan actually go to war?
Hello?
Thank you for staying with us. And we also want to thank Mr. Tavoy Barrett for sharing with us some leadership qualities. You must be humble, be confident, listen to understand. And if you have an attitude, you will have the willingness to do and become the leader that you want to be. All right, so we are now shifting focus to our Star on the Hill feature. This week, we are pleased to welcome a familiar face to Topics on the Hill team, Shanice Davis. So Shanice is a student of the Department of Communication Studies here at NCU and has been our set designer for Topics on the Hill for over a year. But today she is here to share insights about her small business, Documents JA. Welcome to the show, Shanice.
Thank you so much.
As a guest, not the set designer. How are you doing?
I'm good. Thank you so much. It's an honor to be here.
Wonderful.
Awesome. So can you tell us a little about your business and the services you provide?
Sure. Documents Jamaica was founded in 2018. And it's a funny story how I started off providing these services.
Tell us.
I was working at a small company. Mm-hmm. And occasionally, they had a printer at the front, and occasionally I had to, you know, print documents for, for people and so on. And I realized that there was a significant amount of resumes and application letters who just did not fit the standard, you know, and I would tailor those resumes and rewrite their application letters because I wanted them to elevate, you know, I could not see it looking in shambles and print that for them. So it was really from there that I kind of developed the love to help people.
Wow.
And I decided to, because persons started calling me, you know, because of such good service that I give them.
That's awesome.
And then I said, you know what, I'm going to offer this as a service. So we really started off with only resume and application services, but we have added some new services. We are now doing visa applications. We are now doing passport renewal and application services. We're doing resume, CVs, script,
letters,
right, drafting contracts, and so on. Thank you so much.
Right, and you being in the Department of Communication Studies doing PR, you could have never allowed that to happen.
Right.
So with the services that your business provides, what qualifications or experiences do you have that make you adept at handling such important and sensitive tasks?
You just said it, Akeem. I'm from the Department of Communication Studies. I'm a fourth-year student from the US Department at NCU. Hello, somebody. I am studying in public relations. I also had the opportunity to study at Brock University in Canada last year. So I have a knowledge of the local market as well as the international market. And I offer that diversity in whatever I do so my customers are satisfied.
And on that note, what advice would you give to students who want to take up such roles or such positions or start a business like you did?
I say go for it. You know, go for it, because at the time, I didn't know it would my business would have evolved to what it is today. And I really just started with two services. It was just a work from the heart. You know, it was just the love of helping people. And now I'm
doing big things.
You know what I mean?
You've extended.
Right. So for the viewers who are watching, how can they reach you?
Oh, you can reach me on call or on WhatsApp at 876-337-6107 or on Instagram at documents_JA or on TikTok at Documents Jamaica.
So could you repeat that for the person that was in the kitchen just now and not watching?
That's going to be on call or WhatsApp, 876-337-6107, on Instagram, documents_JA, or on TikTok, Documents Jamaica.
Okay, so I'm going to put you on the spot now. You're a public relations student in the Department of Communication Studies here at Northern Caribbean University. So I'm going to give you 30 seconds to sell your business to our audience.
The clock
you
says
can do
now.
It.
Okay. Our clients are always traveling. Do you know why? Because they come to us for visa application services. Our clients are always getting the jobs. Because you know why? We deal with their resume services. Our brand is built in excellence and reliability. If you don't know how, or you just don't have the time, let us handle it. Here at Documents Jamaica, we take the hassle out of writing for you.
All right, I think that was about 40 seconds.
Yes, the time frame was out of the 30 seconds bracket, but that was
well done.
Awesome. Thank you so much for joining us today, Shanice. All the best with your business. We are going to take a break. The exciting candidate reveal is on the other side of this break. Stay tuned.
The United Student Movement. Unite with us. Together, we achieve.
Joining clubs isn't just about finding your niche. It's about unlocking a world of opportunities. The United Student Movement brings together an array of clubs, each offering a unique platform for growth, learning, and connection.
Explore your passions, hone your skills, and expand your horizons. Whether you're an aspiring entrepreneur, an environmental activist, an artist, or a sports enthusiast, there's a club just for you.
My sports host helped me to find a second family away from home.
Through our USM projects team, I have made a real difference in our community.
Being part of the Computer Hardware and Information Processing Specialist Club has really boosted my confidence and critical thinking skills.
Clubs are not just extracurricular. They're the heartbeat of campus life. They provide a network of support, a platform to voice your ideas, and a space to make lasting friendships.
Join the movement and embrace the power of collective action. Stand together, learn from one another, and create a legacy that lasts beyond the classroom.
Ready to dive in? Visit us at usm@ncu.edu.jm and find your place in the United Student Movement. Let your journey begin, because together we're stronger.
Follow us on social media, visit our website, and become a part of something extraordinary. The NCU United Student Movement, where your voice, your ideas, and your passion shape the future. Join us today.
The United Student Movement is the student governing body here on campus. Each year, an election is held, giving you, the students, the opportunity to answer the call to leadership. Students from all departments for the various USM positions. This evening, we have invited the USM Director of Elections, Policies, and Constitutional Affairs for the 2023-2024 regime, Kalia Johnson, to be a part of the candidates' reveal. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you have all been waiting for. So yes. Who is our treasurers?
All right. So
the
candidates who are vying for the position of treasurer, mm-hmm. we have Nathaniel Wilmot and Julian Walker.
For public relations officer, we have Nicholas Ellis, Ashley Wellington, and Sidon Clark.
For sports director, we have Gabrielle Jack and Kalesia Jackson.
For projects, we have Joanne Senior, Crystal Cameron, and Kristen Gale.
For the Director of Elections, Policies, and Constitutional Affairs, we have Dana Lee Barrett and Kamara Brown.
For admin, we have Kimor Wright, Nathaniel Thompson, and Jolene Welsh.
For VP of Spiritual Affairs, we only have one candidate, and that is Anthea Adderley.
Likewise for the VP of Finance, Abian Mitu.
For VP of Student Services and Social Affairs, we have Shanique Wright, Monet Williams, Tonian Barrett, and Jidane France.
For VP of Academics, we have Keila Hart, Ryan Isaacs, and Chevelle Wilson.
And for the position that we all want to know about, the President. We have Bradford Lyons and Richard Bolton.
We wish them all the very best.
So Kalia. There you have it, the candidates. Kalia, thanks for joining us here. So I noticed that some of the positions were missing. Are those positions still open for applications?
Yes, they're very much still open. So persons can still apply for publications director. We still need persons to apply for male sports director, and we are still extending that to treasury and the VP of finance and planning.
So what are some of the important dates that we need to look forward to from today?
important dates to remember. We have the presidential debates, or vice presidential and presidential debates, the 17th and 18th. That's next week, Wednesday and Thursday. We also have the election coming up on the 24th of April. Now, we are aware that that is also in exam period.
Right.
Not to worry. You will be able to vote. And we also have something new and exciting. We have physical booths that will be set up in the gymnasium for persons who need to come in and vote to get that experience. Because, you know, we know that we have students who did not vote local government election. Well, so you get that experience.
This is NCU local government election.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, the United Students Movement. So share some guidelines for the campaign period with us.
One very important thing, and we want to ensure that our candidates know this, and this is coming from the public relations sector, is that ensure that all your flyer, all of your campaign materials go through the various process. So we have to ensure that they all go through student services before you start circulating any of your material. If you are not sure on the font size or the things that are supposed to be on the flyer, these things are already written down for you in the Constitution on page 49 throughout. Another very important a little department there, a little subcommittee is EPOC. That is the Elections Overseeing Committee. So we ensure that everything is smooth. And if you do not adhere to the guidelines of the election, you didn't send up your flyers, you didn't ensure that you were doing a clean election process, and you probably slander, who knows? If you're doing any of those things, you know that you will be disqualified from the race.
So being the director of EPOC, what advice would you give?
EPC, yeah.
EPC.
Hello.
Elections, policies, and current affairs.
Constitutional affairs.
What is wrong with you, Akeem? So what word of advice or encouragement would you give to the candidates?
One of the things that I made sure to mention to them last evening was have fun. You know, we think that it's so hard-pressed and it's so, yes, it's in your face. However, it's important to know that after all of this is said and done, you need to look back at this and you need to be able to smile, to know that you had fun, not just with your team, but have fun with the other candidates. Yes, you're vying for these positions and only one person or maybe two persons can get them. But at the end of the day, have fun. The experience is what you're looking forward to. So don't kill off yourself if you never win, you know? Just remember to have fun, brace yourself, because it's tough, but you can do it.
Okay, wonderful. And are you excited for this election, Marika?
I am looking forward to see who the candidates are going to be. Not just who the candidates are going to be for the positions that are still open, but who will be filling those positions for the 2024 to 2025 school year.
Right.
So on that note, Kalia, thank you so much for being here with us. And all the best to the candidates. We'll be going to a quick break. Stay with us.
Movement. Unite with us, together we achieve.
Joining clubs isn't just about finding your niche, it's about unlocking a world of opportunities. The United Student Movement brings together an array of clubs, each offering a unique platform for growth, learning, and connection.
Explore your passion and expand your horizons. Whether you're an aspiring entrepreneur, an environmental activist, an artist, or a sports enthusiast, there's a club just for you.
My sports host helped me to find a second family away from home.
Through our USM projects team, I have made a real difference in our community.
Being part of the Computer Hardware and Information Processing Specialist Club has really boosted my confidence and critical thinking skills.
Clubs are not just extracurricular. They're the heartbeat of campus life. They provide a network of support, a platform to voice your ideas, and a space to make lasting friendships.
Join the movement and embrace the power of collective action. Stand together, learn from one another, and create a legacy that lasts beyond the classroom.
Ready to dive in? Visit us.
NCU.jm and find your place in the United Student Movement. Let your journey begin, because together we're stronger.
Follow us on social media, visit our website, and become a part of something extraordinary. The NCU United Student Movement, where your voice, your ideas, and your passion shape the future. Join us today.
We have come to the end of not just today's episode, but the end of another season of Topics on the Hill. Akeem and Matthew, happy to have you up here with us.
Right.
I got a promotion.
Which episode was your favorite?
I would say most definitely would be, I think it would be last episode, which was my favorite because of that interview. Akeem, I'm sure you tapped into your inner Dion Jackson Miller with that interview.
Not Dion. Not the Dion.
And you, Akeem, what was your favorite episode?
My favorite was the Christmas when we had that last episode there for last semester. It was my favorite one.
Interesting.
Which one was yours?
Do I have a favorite or I enjoyed all of them? I enjoyed all of them, but I particularly when we discussed about the finance and the technology fee, that discussion, I think it is very important for a student population, and I'm happy that we had that discussion.
And I think you tapped into the Emily Shields of you. Oh, yes. All right, so we want to take this opportunity to say a big thank you to all those of you who contributed to the success of the season six of Topics on the Hill. To our sponsors and advisors, we want to say thank you. And I must say the sponsor for this episode is
Combo Boy by Moy.
Combo Boy, right.
So, Matthew.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you have to say to our audience?
Well, let me tell you something, audience. You are my favorite characters in the show. Not, because best believe, our audience really does make a major part of what we do here, because you have always been consistent with the feedback question.
Yes.
And trust me, the answers have been so dynamic.
And you have been a really, really good host. I see that you enjoy being the social media host.
Oh, yes, most definitely. It's my favorite part of the day, coming on set and just being here with y'all.
Right, so Marika, how was this season for you?
It was a learning experience. Mm-hmm. I must say, I am very happy for the opportunity that I was given to host. I have seen the growth, and I want to say thank you to all the persons who continue to support me and for the feedback each episode. So on that note, before we say goodbye, we want to say thank you to our hardworking production team who continue to give off their best so each episode can be what it is. We also want to say thanks to our producers, our editors, videographers, directors, everyone who works behind the scene to make this happen.
Let's not forget all the special guests who share their stories with us. We've been inspired by student leaders, enlightened by faculty members, and engaged with those leaders who have left an indelible mark on our show.
You know, it's truly been a collaborative effort, and we owe a very big thank you to you, our loyal viewers, for tuning in each week, for your thoughtful comments, and for being an integral part of the conversation. While we're off air, we can still catch up on previous episodes on YouTube at NCU TV Jamaica and keep the discussion going by following us at Instagram at Topics on the Hill.
And so we want to say thank you to Akeem for being our wonderful host, and Matthew.
Right, it has been a wonderful journey. We want to thank you to our producers, editors, videographers, directors, and everyone that has been working on this production behind the scene. Thank you to our Topics in the Street host, Marlene Freeman.
And I can't believe I said thank you to you, Akeem, and thank you to you,
Matthew.
Thank you, Marika.
Did you let me finish?
I was waiting. Go ahead.
Thank you, Marika, for being a wonderful co-host for this season. It's been wonderful. So for the last time this season, we are signing off. Stay curious, stay engaged, and keep striving for the change you wish to see on campus and beyond. We'll see you next season on Topics on the Hill. And as I always say to you, my viewers, with each and every blessing,
count your blessings and name them one by one.
Goodbye, everyone.
Come learn about your school.